What's poppin' YouTube? It's your boy Sabby. Welcome to another episode of Self Mastery. I just got done with the gym, but on my way back, I had a wonderful thought about this topic. 6 major signs that someone is either jealous or envious of you. Now, before I begin, I want to say that stay tuned to this video. I have a lot of information that I will be unpacking, a lot of great tips, a lot of good advice that will help you realize and help you be aware of anybody in your circle, you know, or your inner circle or your family, your in your surroundings, in your environment, of anybody that is jealous or envious of you. And this is a video that I feel like you should save or share with your loved ones or people you feel like could really use this information. Give it a thumbs up if it provides you with any value and stay tuned. Subscribe to my channel. I have a lot of content on many different topics and I have a lot more coming your way. So let's get into it. You see, before I begin, I want to give a small introduction. Anybody can be jealous of you. Like I mentioned, it could be people in your inner circle. It could be your family. It could be your mom and dad. And I know that's surprising to say, but let's go to the mother figure, for example, right? One of my mentors, Michael Tesarion, talks a lot about the dragon mother and the terrible mother. You see, the dragon mother is a good figure, a good mother that raises her kids in a healthy way. But the terrible mother is the malignant or malevolent mother, and she carries that childhood trauma with her and then passes it through generation to generation, meaning she passes it to her own kids. She can be jealous or envious of her own daughter or her own son, right? Or she can try to persuade the son against the father, right? So jealousy and envy can be carried in family as well, in your immediate family. As well as your extended family, you know, like your distant relatives, your cousins, your aunts and uncles. Jealousy can be seen in friends. That's where it's the most common. Co-workers, even your own boss, right? Even the boss at your company could be jealous of your performance or the work that you're putting in or anything, right? Your boss could be jealous. And obviously there's, you know, random people that you've never met that could be jealous of. You could be somebody at your local gym that you go to is probably jealous of what you have going on. Maybe you have a great body or something, right? Great physique, and they're jealous of that. So jealousy is seen among pretty much everybody, right? And I do want to say that, yes, at some point in everyone's life, we all do feel jealous at one point or another. But what separates us all is that some people live in that jealous mode or mode of vibration pretty much a lot of their life, right? And they don't change. And so they stay jealous all the time. That's just, it becomes like second nature to them. It becomes a part of their behavior, a part of their psyche, you know, and that's really what makes a person jealous. Now, there is a slight difference between jealousy and envy, right? Let's talk about jealousy. Jealousy, they see what you have and they want that for themselves. Right? They see maybe that you have the career, you have the girl or the guy, you have the money, you have the success, and they want that for themselves. Obviously, they dislike the fact that you got it, right? They dislike the fact that you got there first, or you got that money, or you got that kind of lifestyle. And deep down, you know, they want those things. But jealousy is not as bad as envy. You see, envy is considered one of the deadliest sins, along with lust, greed, gluttony, wrath. You know, the list goes on, the 7 deadly sins that, you know, you have heard growing up. But envy is one of the deadliest sins. And the reason is because envy is all about hatred, right? Envy is based on hatred. And an envious person will see what you have and they realize that, hey, I cannot attain or I cannot achieve what this person has achieved, right? Maybe you have the money. Maybe you have, you know, the business, whatever. Maybe you have the notoriety or the status or the fame. But deep down, they don't want you to have it either. They want to see you fall down. They want to see you get hurt. They wish harm upon you. You see, envy is a very malignant and malevolent sort of feeling. It's a very narcissistic also, but very, it's just a very bad, that's like the best word I can use. It's a very bad feeling that, you know, I wish nobody dwells upon that, you know, or gets into that mode of vibration, because it literally blackens your heart, right? It makes you into this person that, over time, if you continue in it, you start hurting others, you start harming others. A lot of malignant narcissists, a lot of psychopaths, a lot of sociopaths can be seen as being envious of, you know, whoever they are envious against. So envy is something that is very bad, but then again, people still have slight degrees of envy within themselves. You know, the jealous or envious people do. I'm not going to say everyone out here is a, you know, full-blown psychopath, but just be aware. And these six major signs will show you that, you know, what to look out for or what to be aware of. So without further ado, let's get into it. You know, sign number one. Sign number one that someone is jealous or envious of you is that they try to dim your light, or they try to throw shade on you. In other words, they downplay your achievements. So let's say you just got a promotion and you're getting paid more money, or you just bought yourself a new car, right? You just bought yourself the new model of that Tesla, or maybe you just, you know, you're getting an interview with a big magazine or something like that, right? And you go ahead and tell this person, and maybe you don't even know that this person is jealous or not jealous. You don't know, because, you know, you come with love. You come with, you know, respect to everybody, because that's the kind of person you are. But this person that you tell tries to downplay your achievement, tries to make it seem like it's not a big deal. Like, you know, you're not the hottest thing on the street, you know, like you're not all that. They try to make your achievement seem like it's just average. They try to downplay whatever it is that you've achieved. So maybe you bought that Tesla and you tell them, like, or you show them, like, yo, check out my new car, man. I've worked really hard. I just bought this new car, you know. And they'll be like, oh, Tesla, man. Oh, man, there's so many things that can go wrong with this car, man. It's not worth it, bro. It wasn't worth the money, dude. You should have bought something else, man. Tesla, oh, it's all right, man, you know. Or maybe you bought a little bit of a used Tesla. Maybe you got, you know, a Tesla, like, maybe 3-4 years older than, you know, the current model. And they're like, oh, man, you got the older model? Bro, man, you couldn't get the new one? Or something like that. You know, they're going to try to downplay whatever it is that you have going on. Maybe you're getting paid more money. Maybe you got that promotion at that job. And they're like, man, you're still stuck at a job? Man, yo, you should start your own business, man. Forget that job, bro. You know, why are you stuck in that? Why are you stuck in that, dude? Money, that's nothing, man. That money, dude, taxes will take out a lot of that money, man. So, you know, it's like, they can't even be happy for you. You see, someone that is truly happy for you and you tell them, hey, man, I just got a promotion. They're going to be like, yo, man, let's go celebrate. Let's go get some drinks. Drinks on me, man. Dinner on me tonight, brother. You know, they're going to boast you. They're going to throw love at you. That's someone that's truly happy for you. They're going to join in your enjoyment. They're going to join in your achievement. They're going to feel truly happy for you. But a jealous or envious person will try to downplay any or all of your achievements, right? Will make you seem like you're not a big deal, right? Like you're just normal, man. Like, And that's something you should look out for, something that you should peep, right? Whenever you share good news with somebody, watch out, right? Watch out and look at their reactions. Look at what they say. Look at how they're feeling, right? And that's something you should, you know, analyze internally. Before I go on the second sign, I do want to say, be careful about who you share your good news with. Because sometimes sharing your good news, or I mean to say, sometimes not sharing your good news is the best thing you can do. And the reason I say that, I have another video of, you know, the power of being low key. Check that video out in my channel. There's a lot of power in not sharing your good news, because you have to realize not everybody has the best intentions for you. So be very careful. Now, obviously, if you're sharing it with, you know, your dad or your sister or your brother, and you know they really love you, then yeah, you know, you feel free to share, and you'll see the joy in their faces. You know, you're most of the times, you know, not all the times, but most of the times, your immediate family will be the ones that are most happiest for you. But going to number two sign that you need to look out for is a jealous or envious person will try to copy or imitate you, but act like that idea was theirs, right? Or it was their origination. It was something they did and you followed them. It's like this reverse psychology that they play. It's crazy, right? And one more thing I want to add is that even whatever they copy you doing, they first criticize the fact that you're doing it. And it's funny, right? Maybe, let me give you an example. Maybe you just got, you know, this new hairstyle, you know, whether you're a girl or a woman or a guy watching this, maybe you got a new hairstyle, right? At first, they'll make fun of your hairstyle. They'll be like, yo, what is this, man? Like, yo, that's not looking good on you, man. Yo, you should have done something else, man. Or maybe you got your hair dyed, or maybe you got, you know, highlights in your hair or whatever. And they're going to be like, yo, that doesn't look good. Those highlights don't match you. They don't match your skin tone. They don't look good on you. But then 2-3 weeks later, you'll see that they got the same highlights in their hair, or you'll see they got the same haircut as you. Right? And they'll be like, oh, what do you think about my new haircut? You know, I saw it in a magazine and I was like, I have to get this, right? And you're looking at them like, yo, I have the same haircut. I just got the same haircut. You copied me, bro. Or you copied me, girl. Right? They imitate you. Let's say you're a fashion designer, right? You started designing clothing. And they'll be like, oh man, yo. Your stuff isn't gonna do all that, man. Like, yo, bro, don't do fashion designing, man. Do something else, man. Don't waste your time, bro. You know, there's too many fashion designers out there. But, you know, you love designing, or you love whatever, you know, creation in itself, and you keep working. And then maybe a few months down the road, you see they're designing something, right? They started designing clothing or shoes or whatever, you know, and you're like, wow. This person was just telling me a few months ago not to get into designing, and they're designing now themselves, right? So these kinds of people, these jealous or envious people, start copying you. One big sign of a narcissist, if you're in a relationship with a narcissist, is that a narcissist will mirror you. A narcissist will copy you. And it doesn't always have to be a narcissistic friendship. It could also be a narcissistic relationship, right? Maybe you're a guy dating a girl, or a girl dating a guy, and maybe you love making jewelry or something, handmade jewelry, right? What you'll realize is this guy will start feeling jealous that, hey, you know, you're making jewelry, you're getting sales, you're getting all this and that, you know, you're getting a notoriety with, you know, this creative work that you're doing. They start doing the same thing. So always be aware of people that start copying your swag, or copying your lingo, or the way you talk, or the way you walk, or the way you move, the way you dress. They start copying maybe the people you hang out with. They start trying to become friends with the people you hang out with. Or they start trying to copy just your behavior or whatever. You know, maybe you're into spirituality, and they've never been a spiritual person, but then they get into spirituality, or you're into learning psychology, and they don't even know what psychology is, but then they see you doing it. So down the road, they're into psychology now, and they say they know more than you. Or they say, hey, man, I'm into psychology. Maybe you should get into it too. And it's like, bro, like, I've been on this wave way before you. Like, where have you been, man? Like, but anyways, watch out for that. Watch out for the sign, because people copying you is a big sign of someone that is jealous of you, right? Sign number three. This one is, I think, an important one, but people that see you as an antagonist, right? In other words, people that sort of insult you, or people that try to bring you down, or people that talk behind your back, or people that talk even in front of your face to other people, they try to make you seem like you're not all that, right? Let me give you an example. So maybe, you know, you're out with some new people, or maybe you're out meeting some, you know, friends, or maybe you're at a networking event or whatever, and you take this person with you, and they sort of, you know, bring out your flaws, or they bring out some things that, you know, you've done in the past that you do realize maybe you've made some mistakes, but they highlight those mistakes, right? Or they try to, or they talk behind your back to other people, like, oh, you know, Stacy, man, don't talk to Stacy, man. Like, she's like this, she's like that, you know, she has this, you know, behavior that I don't like, you know, she thinks she's all that. You know, they talk behind your back, or they try to bring you down in front of others, or they make you seem like you're always the bad person, that you're just, you know, full of all these flaws, and they're perfect, right? They always seem like they're perfect. There's nothing wrong with them. It's you. You're the problem. They always make you out to be the antagonist in every situation. That's a jealous or envious person. So watch out for that. Before I even go further, if you even have someone in your life like that that tries to give those jabs at you, or sly insults at you, or talks behind your back to other friends or other people, or always makes you seem like the bad person in every situation, I would say, yo, drop those people, man, like as soon as possible, because it's only going to get worse and bigger as you keep going. So drop that, man. Drop that person, drop whoever it is. Even if it's a family member, right? Maybe you go to these family events and this person's always insulting you, or always making you seem like you're worthless, or you have no value. You don't need to be around these people at all, because deep down, they're just projecting their own insecurities, their own hatred for themselves out on you, their own dislike for themselves out on you. Everything that someone does, remember this, everything that someone does is a projection of their own internal state. Whatever they haven't resolved within, whatever they haven't healed within themselves is what they're going to throw out at you. And that's something you have to understand. It goes back to that quote, hurt people hurt people, right? So people that are hurt within are the people that hurt other people. So you have to realize that these people, man, like deep down, they're not happy with themselves. There's no self-love there. There's no contentment there. Because if someone truly loves themselves, they're going to love others. They're going to love all beings, because deep down they realize the truth of their nature, that they are spirit, and so is everybody else. So is everything else. Everything is spirit, right? And so that love for that spirit channels into love for everything else. But people that haven't gotten there spiritually or mentally yet, they're not going to be like that. So they're going to try to make you, you know, seem to be the bad person in every situation. They're going to hurt you. They're going to try to insult you. They're going to try to do certain things to sort of make it seem like, you know, you're always the bad guy, or, you know, you're just not a good person. But I would say, man, don't even hang out with these people, because at the end of the day, it's just not worth it. Number four sign that someone is jealous or envious of you is simply the fact that they just ignore you. Or they don't show up when it's like maybe your birthday, or they don't celebrate when it's a celebration celebrating you, right? Or maybe they don't text you back. Maybe they don't pick up your phone calls or whatever, because deep down they just don't like you, man. They just don't. They're just jealous of you. They're envious of you, right? And so what's gonna happen is that, let's say, you know, it is your birthday party, and you know you've invited all your loved ones and all your close people, and this person that you thought is your friend, or you know is someone that you really care about, someone that you know has been in your circle for a long time. You invite them, but they don't show up, right? They don't show up. Or maybe, you know, it's maybe you know you're going out for drinks or something like that, celebrating a new promotion or whatever. They're nowhere to be seen, right? The reason is why these people are always ignoring you or never coming to your hangouts or events whenever it's a celebration for you is because they know deep down that if they are around you at that moment, they won't be able to fully express the joy that other people will be able to express for you. They know that they cannot be fully happy in your celebration. So they try to avoid coming. They try to avoid talking to you. They try to avoid being seen when it's something celebrating you, because they know deep down that they just don't feel that way within about you or what you have achieved, right? So they try to distance themselves to keep that envy or jealousy within themselves, right? That's one thing you got to watch out for, because, you know, especially when it comes to like family and friends, you know, and people are sort of, you know, trying to act like they don't know you, or they're trying to act like, hey man, like you're not really close to them or they're not close to you. It's all because, you know, they just don't want to be near you. They just don't want to be near your success. And they hate you for the fact that you have the success. And because of that, you know, they're looking for ways to not come in contact with you. So be aware of anybody. Be aware of any of your friends, any of your colleagues, maybe your coworkers, or anybody that, you know, when there's something big that you are celebrating, even could be like, you know, just a simple fact that maybe somebody in your family got married or whatever, right? They're not going to come. They're not going to come because they don't really care about you. You know, deep down, they don't really care about you. Deep down, they don't want to see any part of your life win. They don't want to see it. They don't want to be near that. Because if they do come, right, that jealousy is going to show. That envy is going to show. That hatred for you is going to show. And it's going to show right on their face. It's going to show, you know, on their face, but also in their body expressions and in the way that they move. You have to understand that sometimes that the most obvious signs of jealousy are not always the insults, right? It's not always the insult. It's not always the throwing the shade or the remarks or anything like that. It's sometimes, or most of the times, things that are not said, things that are not seen. It's behind closed doors, right? It's stuff that is more like hidden. It's kept within that person. They try to keep that jealousy within themselves. They don't try to really express it out loud, right? So you got to watch out for those hidden signs. You got to watch out for those hidden expressions. And, you know, if you ever share news with somebody, look at their face, right? Look at their face. See what kind of facial expressions that they make or what kind of energy is coming out. Be aware of that, you know? Anyways, sign number 5, they're always in a competition with you. This is a big sign of someone that is jealous of you, is that they're always trying to out-compete you. They're always trying to outdo you. They're always trying to be the better person, right? Because deep down, they know that they're not worthy. They know deep down that they're not at your level. And because of that, what they do is, let's say maybe you went to a trip in Italy, right? And you're sharing with your friends, you're sharing with the group. And then what they do is they pull out pictures of them going to Brazil. And they're like, hey man, Italy, it's overrated, man. Check out these pictures from Brazil that I went to, man. And, you know, it's not even from a place of like where everyone is sharing all their trips. It's just the fact that because you're sharing your trip in Italy, they're trying to outdo you with their trip in Brazil, right? Or let's say you just, you know, have been eating healthier, right? Or you've been sort of working out the gym and you're slowly starting to get these muscles coming in, right? You can start seeing a couple of your first set of abs coming in, or maybe your legs are getting bigger. Maybe, you know, your body's getting more in shape. What they're going to do is they're going to try to downplay your achievement and make it seem like, hey, I've been hitting the gym longer, right? My body's way better, right? You still have this and that to work on. You still have fat in your lower abdomen, right? Your exercises could be better, right? Your diet could be better. They're going to try to point out all the flaws with your routine and your exercise regimen and all that, while theirs is the best, while theirs is like top notch, while they know what they're talking about, right? Or maybe you're running your business and you think that, hey, you know, this is the best way I want to take my business. This is the kind of road I want to take my business on. These are the decisions I'm thinking about making for my business. What they do is they see you, right? But they downplay your decisions. They're like, no, don't do this, don't do that. You know, let me show you the way, because I know more about your business than you know about your business, even though I don't even have the same business as you, right? And it's like they're going to try to outcompete all your decisions, all your achievements, anything that you do. They're going to try to outcompete that. They're going to try to make it seem like you're not all that, right? You're nothing compared to them. They're better. And then again, it goes back to my last video, what I said, right? People want to see you do good, but never better than them. So be aware of that. If someone's always trying to outcompete you, and it doesn't even have to be direct competition, it's like, let's say maybe you post a picture or something of you where, you know, you've achieved some sort of success. Then the same day or the next day, they post something of their own success on social media, right? Or let's say maybe, you know, you get a girlfriend or something, and next thing you know, they're trying to get a girlfriend, or they're trying to get a hotter girlfriend than you, or a hotter boyfriend than you, or something like that, because they're in secret competition with you, right? They, deep down, they're trying to beat you. They look at you as someone that's their competitor, rather than someone that's a true friend, someone that they can truly love and truly, you know, be happy in their happiness with, right? So they don't look at you like that. They look at you as a challenge. They look at you as someone that they need to overcome and beat. And it's like, my thing is, why even be friends with someone like that? Why try to be friends with someone that, and you're not even in competition with these people, right? You're just living your life. You're just doing what you want to do. You're just trying to better yourself. You're just trying to, you know, aim for the things that you want to achieve, or aim for the things that, hey, man, like, you've always wanted to do or wanted to attain. And they're out here like trying to beat you, and they might not even want the same things that you, but they try to follow your goals because they want to beat you at your own goals, but those aren't even their goals. And it's like, whoa, like you're just like out of, like, I'm, it's just, you know, it's a lot. That's all I can say. It's a lot. So try not to be friends with these kinds of people, man. Cut them off, let them go. Because down the road, it's only going to get worse. Down the road, it's only going to be something that you eventually have to just cut off. And it's better you end it when you start seeing the first signs, rather than letting it continue until it grows into something bigger than it needs to be. Now, sign number 6. This is the last sign I'm going to share with you guys. This is something that is not something that they exhibit in their behavior, but this is something that is within you. It's a mental faculty called intuition. So always trust your intuition. Always trust your inner guidance, right? If you know, or if you feel in the core of your stomach, in your gut, that you feel that this person is jealous of you, you feel that, hey, I always get weird vibes from this person. I always have this feeling when I'm around this person that this person doesn't want the best for me, or this person doesn't have the best intentions for me, or I feel like, man, this person's always like up to something behind my back. I feel like this person, you know, is not to be trusted, or is not to be confided in. If you have this kind of feeling, this intuitive feeling, and look, intuition can work through dreams. It can work through a vision, or it can just be something that you can feel physically throughout your body. It's just like this sick feeling maybe you get, where you feel sick to your stomach because you realize that this is not where you need to be right now. This is a bad situation to be in right now, right? You ever been in one of those like dark alleyways at night, and you're like, you feel those like goosebumps, and you're just like, oh man, I should not be in this alley right now, because that's your intuition telling you, get out of there. right? So same thing with these kinds of jealous or envious people. If the pit of your stomach or if everything in your body is telling you, get out of this friendship, get out of this relationship, or, you know, cut this family member off right now, do it. Follow your intuition. That's a big, big, big sign that someone is jealous or envious of you. And that's something you have to follow, because intuition is God speaking to us. Intuition is spirit or your guides, your angel guides, or the universe letting you know that, hey, this person is not to be trusted. This person is bad news. This person is malevolent. Get out of here right now before things get chaotic, right? So always follow your intuition. Never ever doubt your gut feeling. Never ever second guess your gut feeling, right? Your gut feeling is, I would say, 100% always correct, because intuition is powerful. It's like animal, it's like comparable to the animal instinct, right? Because the body has an intelligence of its own that sometimes our conscious mind cannot pick up on, right? Sometimes our conscious mind can be so deluded by the programming or conditioning of society that, you know, it is through our body, through our intuition, that we are aware of, hey, you know, these are bad vibes. I gotta leave right now because, you know, things are gonna get crazy. So these are six signs, I would say, to watch out for, that someone or anybody around you in your inner circle, family, friends, coworkers, colleagues, whatever, is jealous and or envious of you. And so the best thing to do is cut these people off, move on, right? Find new friends. If you can't find new friends right now, be alone for a while until better people are attracted to you, right? But don't be surrounded by the wrong company. It's better to be alone than to be in the presence of someone that doesn't wish the best for you, right? You don't want to be surrounded by the wrong people. I always say that to everybody, that be careful of who you let into your private life, who you let into your inner circle. Always be aware. The big news for today is I will be sharing my email in the description below. If you guys have any questions, comments, concerns, or just anything you want to share, or any video requests, leave a email or send me an email, and I will definitely get back to you in a timely manner. Obviously, no, I am busy. I am running a business, but I will definitely respond to you. And that's about it for today's video. I do have a lot more content coming out, so do subscribe to my channel. Give this video a thumbs up if it provided you with any information or any knowledge or any value. Share it. Save it, give it to somebody that you know can make use of it. Other than that, thank you so much for tuning in. It's been your boy, Sabby. Welcome to the Empowerment Channel, Self-Mastery. Happy holidays. Merry Christmas if I don't see you guys before then, but take care and peace.